ثم ذكر مسألة أخرى أيضا داخلة في الإيمان باليوم الآخر والإيمان بالغيب، وهو الأحاديث أو الاعتقاد بحوض نبينا صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم القيامة.
And the author mentioned another aspect from the affairs of the day of judgment, which one must believe in, and the affairs of the unseen, and that is the belief in the lake, the hawd, on the day of judgment.
قال ثم الإيمان بأن لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حوضا ترده أمته كما صح عنه، وأنه كما بين عدن إلى عمان البلقاء يعني الأردن، وروي من مكة إلى بيت المقدس وبألفاظ أخر.
And so this is to believe that the hawd, the pool or the lake of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, that his nation will drink from it, as is authentically reported from him عليه الصلاة والسلام, and to believe that it is like that which is between Aden and Amman of Al-Balqa, which is Amman of Jordan, and likewise it has been narrated that its distance is like the distance between Makkah and Bayt al-Maqdis, and with various alternative wordings as well concerning the size of the hawd.
أما الحوض فقد دل عليه القرآن والسنة والإجماع.
As for the pool or the lake, then no doubt this the proof has been reported in the Quran regarding it, as well as the Sunnah, and as well as by way of consensus.
قال تعالى إنا أعطيناك الكوثر.
Allah said, indeed we have given you الكوثر.
الكوثر كما ورد في الحديث له نهر يصب ماؤه في الحوض.
And Kawthar, as it's come in the hadith, is a river that whereby its water, na'am, it goes into the pool.
ورد جملة من الأحاديث في قدر حوض النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، قال كما بين أيلة في الشام وصنعاء في اليمن، وأن فيه أكوابه أو كيزانه بعدد نجوم السماء.
Likewise, in the authentic narrations show you the size of the pool of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, or the lake of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. Some mention that it is from Ayla in Yemen all the way to Sham, and some mention it's from Sana'a. Na'am. Ayla ila Sana'a, Ayla being in Sham and Sana'a being in Yemen. Yani from Sham all the way to Yemen, showing you the size of the pool. And also the other narrations which mention يعني more details regarding it, which the Sheikh is going to mention inshallah.
وجاء أيضا في ألفاظ أخر أنه كما بين صنعاء والمدينة.
And some other narrations mention that is between صنعاء and Medina.
ورد في حديث أبي هريرة قال له أشد بياضا من الثلج وأحلى من العسل.
And in narration of Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه that he mentioned that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned that it is whiter than milk and sweeter than honey.
وأحاديث الحوض متواترة حتى أنه ذكر أن رواته يزيدون على 50 صحابيا.
And the narrators that have narrated the hadith of the hawd يعني number more than 50 narrators. And the Sheikh also mentioned about the description of the hawd is that its cups are like the amount of stars in the sky.
وثبت أن الحوض مربع الشكل بقوله طوله شهر وعرضه شهر.
And also the narration that mentions the Prophet mentioned that its length and its width are both a month's distance in journey, and this shows you that it is actually square shaped.
ورد أنه حين يكون الناس عطشا يوم القيامة يأتون ويردون حوض رسول الله ويشربون منه.
Also is mentioned that the pool on the day of the pool of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, the people will come to it and they will drink from it. And it is mentioned that those who drink from it, they will never feel thirsty ever again after that.
ورد أنه يطرد عنه أقوام هم الأهل الردة وأهل البدع والأهواء، وهذا من عقوبة المبتدع أنه يطرد عن حوض النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. تقول الملائكة إنك لا تدري ما أحدثوا بعدك.
Also, it is reported that there are people who will be rejected from drinking from the pool, and from them is the people who leave Islam, who left Islam, and from them are the people of desires and the people of innovation. For indeed, it is reported that the angels themselves will say, You do not know what they have changed after you.
وإذا نظرنا إلى هذه الأحاديث في ذكر المسافة الحوض نجد هذا الاختلاف في هذه المسافات فبعضها أطول من بعض.
So when we look at the different wordings regarding the distance of the size of this hole, of the pool, then we say that we see that some mention some lengths more than others.
مثلا هذه من عدن إلى عمان مسافة هي أطول من مكة إلى بيت المقدس.
For example, the distance between عدن and عمان, that's a bigger distance than between صنعاء and مكة.
مكة وبيت المقدس.
مكة and بيت المقدس. There's a difference between the sizes.
أطول من الحديث الآخر من صنعاء إلى المدينة.
And that is also, you find it longer or bigger in distance than صنعاء to Medina.
والجمع بين ذلك أهل العلم قالوا.
So how do we gather together between these different narrations?
الوجه الأول.
Scholars said that the first angle we say.
أن المسافة الأقل تدخل في المسافة الأكبر. بمعنى أنه لو قلنا من صنعاء إلى المدينة أو من صنعاء إلى الشام المسافة الأقل تدخل في المسافة الأكبر.
So if we say for example صنعاء to Medina and or as in other narration صنعاء to Sham, then the scholars have mentioned that actually the shorter distance actually enters the longer distance that is mentioned.
والوجه الثاني قالوا أن المسافة هنا تختلف باختلاف السير وسرعته. فالأقل يكون مثلا بالخيل والأطول تكون بالمشي كما هو معلوم.
Another angle of answering this doubt is that we say, as the scholars mentioned, that actually if you were to travel between these two distances by horse, it's not like if you were to walk. So those that mention longer distance, then no doubt that could be an answer. That was by walking. The other one was by horse. So that could be an answer to bring together these narrations.
قال ماؤه أشد بياضا من اللبن وأحلى من العسل وأكوابه عدد نجوم السماء. رواه عبد الله بن عمر وعبد الله بن عمر وأبي بن كعب وأبو ثور وثوبان مولى رسول الله وأبو أمامة الباهلي ويزيد الأسلمي رضي الله عنهم أجمعين.
And this narration that the author brings, its water is whiter than milk and sweeter than honey, and its cups are like the amounts of stars in the sky, narrated by Abdullah ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Amr, and Ubay ibn Ka'b, and Abu Thawr, and Thawban, and Abu Umama, and Yazid al-Aslami radiallahu anhum ajma'in. May Allah be pleased with them all.
قال العبد دائما أن يسأل الله عز وجل ليكون ممن يرد هذا الحوض ويشرب منه.
And it's upon the servant of Allah to continuously to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he or she will be granted to drink from this pool, this lake, that's for the messenger alayhi salatu salam, that is given to him, that we drink from this pool.
كان أنس رضي الله تعالى عنه يقول لقد تركت عجائز المدينة وهم أو ما تصلي واحدة منهن صلاة إلا سألت ربها أن يريدها حوض محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And Anas رضي الله عنه said, as is reported, that he said, I left the old ladies of Medina. There isn't any one of them that except when they pray, they always ask Allah to grant them that they drink from the pool of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام.
نسأل الله عز وجل أن يجعلنا وإياكم والدين منهم.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us and yourselves and our parents from them.